New Zealand. Home of rugby, Kiwis of both the bird and fruit variety, Lord of the Rings, and that guy who made Thor Ragnarok. But that's just what normal people think of when they hear New Zealand. What I think of is schlocky horror movies made by none other than Peter Jackson. That's right, before he was all high and mighty with Lord of the Rings and King Kong, he made some pretty interesting B-movies that I think are weird, and most normal people think of as disturbing. He's made such classics as Brain Dead, Meet the Feebles, and Bad Taste, but while those movies are excellent, we're not here to talk about them today. Today we'll be talking about New Zealand's number one export, black sheep. Apparently, there are 40 million sheep in New Zealand, and they're pissed off. I don't know how one counts all those sheep, but apparently this movie has. This is probably the closest thing to an actual horror film that I've covered so far, unless you're scared of guys in rubber suits and prosthetics. This might be the weirdest one though, so strap in. Our movie opens with an idyllic shot of people driving around beautiful New Zealand on ATVs, herding sheep. Also, spooky music plays over the rather bland title card of this movie, which is a nice contrast against things to come. We cut to a kid holding an axe over a sheep, which I'm sure is gonna end just fine. Meanwhile, another kid goes into a barn, where kid number one disturbingly scars him by wearing the bloody skin of the sheep he just killed, like Hercules with a Nemean lion skin. I don't know why someone would think this is a prank. I mean, you're covered in blood. That's like psychological warfare. Our young Leatherface is interrupted by an old woman, who tells our young child that there's been an accident.
It's your father. There's been an accident.
Cut to 15 years in the future, when we meet our unfortunate victim, Henry, having a panic attack in a taxi as sheep clogged the road. Now, I've never seen a sheep and I don't believe New Zealand exists, but is this a real problem? Do hordes of sheep randomly clog the road? Do traffic reports take into account whether old McDonald's sheep are feeling adventurous that day? Whatever. We find out Henry's on his way to his old family ranch, because of therapy reasons, to sell off his share to his psychopath of a brother, Angus. On his way there, we cut to some very obvious hippies, or whatever we call them nowadays. Hipsters? Millennials? We find out they're planning to do a little investigative journalism due to some shady things they've been hearing about the Oldfield Ranch. We cut back to Henry, arriving at the ranch, as he nearly gets his head blown off by his old maid or housekeeper or whatever. He then goes to find his brother, Angus, who's preparing to give a speech, and they spout exposition that I didn't really hear because the volume on this movie is pretty quiet. Something about therapy or mental scarring, I couldn't hear.
And my therapist said I should come. Therapy.
Cut back to your friendly neighborhood eco-terrorists, who see some shady stuff going on at a nearby abandoned-looking building. And the guy, who's named Grant, decides he needs to get some evidence harder than pictures, and goes to steal something that the scientists are throwing away. His partner named, and I'm not kidding, Experience, doesn't like this. They escape from the pursuing scientists, but not before Experience yells at him. During the chase, he trips and shatters the container he was holding, which contains what I can only describe as a zombie sheep fetus. It bites him, and we get a lovely scene of him playing tug-of-war on his earlobe with a puppet, eventually ripping it off. Cut back to Henry, who's receiving a hefty sum from his brother for his share of the farm. We cut back to the sheep crawling away from poor Grant, which transitions into housekeeper making something like haggis. I don't know what New Zealanders eat. They talk, and she tries to give him an award his father won, which I'm sure won't come back into play later in the film. An old friend of Henry's, Tucker, arrives, and they go off to do sheep farmer stuff. The sheep fetus from earlier comes back and baas for help, but it's unfortunately a wolf in sheep's clothing, as it bites the sheep coming towards it. Cut back to Henry and Tucker, who are talking, until they almost hit a sheep in the middle of the road. Then we get a nice scene of Tucker using professional sheep-moving techniques to get the sheep out of there. However, Experience steals their gun and attempts to hijack them, but is easily tricked into handing it over, which is just really funny.
Safety's on.
What?
Safety's on. Yeah, on the other side. Back a bit, and down. Back and down, up. Here. There we go, yeah, right.
They try to go look for Grant, but can't find him. Meanwhile, we see a man get attacked by something in the comfort of his own home. Poor fella. Also, Grant is out in the woods having a mild panic attack, but it looks like he's recovering thanks to that whoops. Guess not. Henry and Tucker decide to take Experience back to her car, but get distracted when they see smoke and go to investigate. After a few fake-out scares, it turns out the man was torn apart by something, which soon reveals itself. But wait a second, that's just a sheep. Surprise! It's a very bitey sheep. Henry is both scared out of his mind, but also feeling a little vindicated, I'm sure. After some nice shooting by Tucker, they make an escape from the house. However, Henry is petrified because the house is just absolutely surrounded by sheep and needs some help getting out. So Experience uses some hippie meditation mumbo jumbo that actually works.
Feel the energy drawing out of the soil. Can you feel it?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I'll take a moment here to mention a slightly interesting aspect of the film, which is the fact that until a certain point, you can't really tell which sheep are evil. Which is a little neat, I guess. That is, until Henry's meditation is ruined and they rush to the truck, where they find Tucker wrestling with a particularly nasty little guy. Take a look. Unfortunately, even with help from a chainsaw, these grown adults are overpowered by a sheep, so they decide to careen the truck over a cliff. This also turns out to be the cliff where Henry's dad dies, but that's irrelevant and doesn't come back into play, so forget about that. They elect to hike back to civilization so they can raise the alarm about the sheep gone mad. Meanwhile, Grant stumbles out of the woods where, by chance, he encounters Angus, and the two get into a shouting match. Both men make excellent points in their debate, but Grant's bite is much worse than his bark, and the two part ways. Meanwhile, Sergeant Shepard's Lonely Hearts Club is having some of my favorite kind of dialogue, witty banter.
I would have thought that you of all people would appreciate efforts to deconstruct the colonialist, paternalistic, agrarian hierarchy that disenfranchises the Tonga Te Whenua and erodes the natural resources of Aotearoa.
This is unfortunately interrupted by Tucker, who seems to have been bitten by the sheep, all the way through steel-toed boots, somehow. They remove the boot to address the wound and oh my god, what is that? Wow. I've heard of having a leg of lamb, but this is ridiculous. They hear bleeding, indicating doom is near, and hobble towards that abandoned building thing from the beginning, where they plan to take shelter. Unfortunately, this building has been turned into a laboratory and not the Dexter's kind. Well, I guess the Dexter the serial killer kind. There's some weird sheep with his heart still pumping, stuff in jars, the whole shebang. Angus also shows up, along with a mad scientist lady, and they drug Tucker, while Henry and Experience make their escape. But not before some exposition.
Angus, are you nuts?
There's a lot riding on this, Henry. I told you, it's going to be very profitable.
However, they are surrounded and chased into an offal pit, which I had heard about but never seen before. For those curious, they're pits where sheep guts are thrown into, and apparently New Zealand is full of them. Neat. Anyway, Henry and Experience fall in as Angus taunts them. He then talks to the crate from Jurassic Park.
All he had to do was leave. Why wouldn't he do that?
Meanwhile, Henry and Experience are slipping and sliding in small intestines, and Henry somehow knows that offal pits are connected to cave networks. But the sheep which were previously held back by like three strands of wire are sounding close, so they take off into the caves. Here we get a nice claustrophobic sequence of crawling through tunnels, even to the point where Experience has a panic attack and Henry uses the same hippie talk that calmed him down on her.
Your tree.
Tree.
Feel your roots in the ground? Feel your,
Chakra.
However, he does it while kicking a sheep in the face, so it's not the same. They eventually make it out the other side and go to look for some place to wash off, because even as a horror fan who watched somebody dissolve last episode, this is just kinda gross. Henry and Experience are washing off when they hear the sound of somebody getting a shave. They investigate and see Grant, who looks a little different from earlier. I think it's a new haircut. He chases our heroes through a shearing station or something, I don't know. Eventually our heroes are cornered, but through the power of vegetarianism, they buy enough time to escape.
Have you been eating meat, Grant? Was it even organic?
While this goes on, poor Tucker is having some dental and eyesight trouble, and they look bad. Luckily, Dr. Crazy is nearby to help, and she injects fluid from a weird tube into him. He has a sheep transformation seizure. However, he seems to be fine, and mad scientist lady goes to do more evil stuff. However, on her way out, she is chased by sheep who seem to have eaten some of her coworkers, and she meets her own unfortunate end, which I just love to see in movies like this. The creator being destroyed by its creation, it's so poignant. Back at the ranch, Angus is preparing for his big unveiling of his newest project, but is looking really under the weather. He unveils his creation, a really, really white sheep. I'm not a sheep farmer, so I don't know if it's different than a normal one, but there's something that's so unsettling about it. I just can't put my finger on it. Unfortunately, this big event is interrupted by a tidal wave of fleece bearing down on the poor attendees. The event turns into a slaughterhouse, and we see just how destructive sheep can be. Angus retreats to the house, having been sheepishly outdone. Henry and Experience arrive at the house as night approaches, and find the housekeeper, who plans to help them defend it. However, Grant has tracked them to the house, and a fight scene in the kitchen takes place, where we find out that instead of silver, weresheep are weak to lamb sauce. If only Gordon Ramsay were here.
Where's the lamb sauce?
Also, Henry takes his dad's trophy to use as a weapon. Grant is paralyzed using acupuncture techniques, which, do those even work on sheep? Henry stops in Angus's office, where Angus has begun his transformation. Also, we get the reveal that Angus may be a little too in love with sheep farming, and to put it politely, donated to his genetic research. This results in that weird-looking sheep being the newest member of Angus's and Henry's family, if you catch my drift.
Well, it's more of a spam sample, really.
You wanker.
The heroes retreat upstairs, where they see the farm is overrun with sheep and were-sheep alike. Also, poor Henry's been infected, and meditation is tried once more.
You're a tree.
I'm not a tree. I'm a fucking sheep.
Comedy comes in threes, people. Henry spies Angus heading to the barn, where he has a plane stash that he can use to escape and infect the whole country. Henry won't let this happen, but first escorts the girls to a car that they can use to escape. Henry gets an ID and disguises himself as a sheep, which works a little too well for reasons we won't be showing here, but you can kind of see where I'm going with this. He realizes that because he was bit, he's got pheromones or something, so sheep register him as one of their own. A black sheep, perhaps, but a member of the flock nonetheless. He makes it to the barn in time to see Angus start to transform, but he's having none of that as he stabs him with his dad's award. Real nice Chekhov's gun moment. Unfortunately, that award was not made of lamb sauce, so Angus fully transforms in a moment that I bet was stolen from one of those American Werewolf in a Foreign Country movies. You know the ones. Angus and Henry fight, and it looks like the sheep man has the upper hand. The plane in the barn gets started and smashes through the door, beginning to become a hazard like in that one Indiana Jones movie with the Nazis. No, not that one. The other one. Yeah, that one. Luckily, a dog that's kind of been in the movie, but not really, comes to the rescue, and uses his sheepdog training to hold the sheep man in place, which really goes to show how dumb sheep are. The plane is cleared for takeoff, but something seems to get stuck in the propeller, turning it off its course. Henry turns around, obviously thinking victory, but unfortunately, like a WWE wrestler, Angus rises from the mat. But what's this? Tucker to the rescue? He shoots that weird fluid into Angus, who collapses, and then feeds it to Henry, who has a mini seizure like Tucker. They gather up all the killer sheep, but realize they can't cure them all. Angus, somehow not dead despite taking a literal plane propeller to the back, wanders into the sheep, and I had to watch sheep eat a little bit of blood sausage, if you understand what I'm saying. The things I do for this channel. He's devoured by his flock, and the heroes remember some throwaway line about methane, and bring the sheep to an explosive end. Insert your own fart joke here. I'm not gonna stoop to that level. The story ends with Tucker, Henry, and Experience turning the were-sheep back into normal people, where they will surely have psychological scarring and a craving for grass for the rest of their life. Also, Experience is tricked into eating mountain oysters, which I'm not gonna explain. Google it yourself. The film concludes on a shot of that poor dog who baas, making him a black sheep among his peers. My overall opinion of this movie is very positive, and yet I can't say that it's perfect. It takes a little bit to really get going. Some of the parts are slow, and there are a couple parts that I think are just really unimportant. However, this is a very well done movie. The humor is thought out and lands perfectly. The gore is gross, and the premise sufficiently ridiculous, making this a movie that's fun to watch by yourself or with friends. Pro tip, trick your friends into watching this by telling them you're watching Black Sheep starring Chris Farley. That's all for today's episode. Please be sure to come back next time, we'll be covering the unofficial sequel to this movie, Shaun the Sheep. Thank you very much for watching, and remember, Weirdflix watches what no one else will.